What's happened over the last 60 years plus is that all sorts of non-competitive statutes and provisions have been put into law. And so we're going to try to clear all those out, let the craft brewing industry do what they're good at, brew beer and sell it to the public. And what we've learned is that there's really no opposition other than the kind of powerful Annapolis alcohol lobby, which doesn't like to have any kind of democracy applied to it. So I happen to think we're going to make Maryland the number one state in the country within 2 years. We'll double the number of craft beer being produced, and we'll improve the state's business reputation. Say you invest your sweat, your money, your everything, you use your labor to produce a beer that's really popular. In order to sell it in Maryland, you have to inevitably go to a distributor. Well, the distributor that you pick is, you better be sure it's the right one, because you're married for life. There's no divorce in the Maryland franchise laws. It's either you like us and stay with us, or we put you out of business. And so that kind of ancient law that had some logic back in the 1930s and 1940s makes no sense now, and we need to adjust it. Lots of other provisions about what the hours are for wonderful places like Denizens, how late they can stay open, how much of their own beer they can sell. It's just one impediment after another, and it all adds up to Maryland's reputation as a beer unfriendly state.
Essentially, right now, if you're a brewery that's successful and you're looking to expand your operations, hire more people, make more beer, the way the law exists right now, you're not allowed to do that. And so, very specifically, I would like to see those restrictions taken away so that businesses who are successful can continue to be successful.